Hello friends, we are fourth year students of Pioneer Homeopathic Medical College, Vadodara. And it is a great pleasure in sharing an academic fest from this platform. We hope and believe that this video would become very much helpful to medical fraternity, whether you are a student or practicing homeopathy. Before we begin the topic, we are thankful to our teachers who guided us and our Pioneer Institute who gave us the platform to make this event possible. Now, let's say about the topic. We all have witnessed an unfortunate news about an untimely death, especially in young people, in recent past. And all the reason behind is heart attack. As it is a topic of concern, we have made our sincere efforts to convey a practical detail about heart attack, a coronary syndrome. Now, let us begin with the topic.
Hello everyone, myself Sheikh Naushin, a student of 4th year BHMS from Pioneer Homeopathic Medical College. Today, in this video, I will explain you about the anatomy of heart, physiology of circulation, and along with it, we will also discuss about the indication and contraindication of angioplasty.
Myself Divya Surani from the Pioneer Homeopathic Medical College, student of 4th BHMS, is going to explain you about the procedure of angioplasty.
My name is Sekhar Shah and I am the student of 4th year BHMS from Pioneer Homeopathic Medical College and I will perform the procedure of angioplasty in dummy model of the heart.
So now let's start our video with anatomy of heart. Today we will understand the anatomy through the model prepared by our vet. So this is a model of heart prepared by our vet. In this model, heart has four channels. The first is right atrium, then right ventricle, left atrium and then left ventricle. Here we have shown the veins with blue color and the arteries with red color. So the major vessels which are present here is, the first is superior vena cava, then inferior vena cava, then pulmonary artery, pulmonary veins, ascending aorta, arch of aorta and the branches of the arch of aorta. Now the heart also has its blood supply through two major arteries known as coronary artery. So the coronary artery is further divided into left coronary artery and right coronary artery. Left coronary artery is further divided into left circumflex artery and left anterior descending artery. They are also further divided into so many branches. Similarly, right coronary artery is also further divided into so many branches and they supply the different portion of heart. So this is all regarding to the anatomy of heart through our model.
After learning anatomy, we will proceed to our physiology of heart. Now, deoxygenated blood from various parts of body enters the heart into the right atrium of heart through superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. Now, this blood enters into right ventricle through the valve known as tricuspid valve. Now, this deoxygenated blood enters into lungs for the process of oxygenation through the artery known as pulmonary artery. This pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood from right ventricle of heart to the lungs for the process of oxygenation. Now, the oxygenated blood enters to the left atrium of heart through pulmonary vein. This oxygenated blood from left atrium enters into left ventricle from the valve known as mitral valve. After the left ventricle, this oxygenated blood enters into aorta through aortic valve and then it enters to the different tissue of the body and supply oxygenated blood to each and every part of the body. All regarding to the physiology of heart. So now, after learning anatomy and physiology, our basics should be clear. So we will proceed to the next step of our video, which are the indication and contraindication of angioplasty. So let's first understand what are the indications of angioplasty. So the first main indication for the angioplasty is acute ST elevation myocardial infarction. The second main indication is non-ST elevation myocardial infarction. The third indication is persistent angina pain in spite of so many medical treatment given and there is no relief for it. There are many other indications are there, but these three are the basic one. So now indication, after learning indication, it is very necessary
Now, the second contraindication is if there is a block in multiple vessels and there is so many vessels are included, then we have to more preferable and there is more advisable CABG rather than angioplasty. The third contraindication is if there is bleeding disorder is there or any no platelet count is there. It is not an absolute contraindication, but it is a relative contraindication. The fourth contraindication is if there is any disease of kidneys there or any high creatinine level comes, then it becomes a relative contraindication. Because in angioplasty, we are using dye which can cause harm to the kidney. So this is all regarding the anatomy, physiology, contraindication and indication of angioplasty.
PTCA, percutaneous transmembrane coronary angioplasty. Percutaneous means through the skin, transmembrane into the lumen of the vessel, up to the coronary, and angioplasty means we are dilating the narrow segment of the coronary artery. So we are actually inserting the catheter through the skin into the lumen of the vessel, up to the coronary artery and dilating the narrow segment of the coronary artery. This is the brief meaning of the PTCA. PTCA was actually introduced by the Dr. Andreas Grubelsieg in the 1977 as an alternative to coronary bypass surgery. But the concept was initially demonstrated by the Dr. Charles Lauter in the 1964, but in the peripheral arteries, not in the coronary arteries. Then the introduction of the stent came in the 1994, which was a major advance in this field because it helps in reducing the acute complication like acute thrombosis and the late stenosis. Then the further reduction in the late stenosis was achieved by the introduction of drug-eluting stent in the 2003. What is the PTCA? Actually, PTCA involves the balloon dilatation accompanied by coronary stenting, which is widely used to achieve the revascularization of the myocardium, especially in the symptomatic ISD patient. And the symptoms would be like the chest pain, the breathlessness, dyspnea, the pain may radiate towards the jaw, under side of the arm, and the forearm towards the epicastric region into the interscapular region, and may also have the cold perspiration, and also used to achieve the suitable stenosis of the epicardial arteries. Then for the suitable stenosis of the epicardial arteries. Now we will talk about the procedure. Before procedure, during procedure and after the procedure. Now before the procedure, the patient has to follow various criteria like investigation. In those investigation, we will talk about the blood test. In the blood test is the CBC, CRP, then triple H, that is HCV, HIV, HBsAg, troponin I, and the PTINR. These are the various investigations which would be mandatory for the patient to do before this procedure. Now, other than blood test is the ECG and echo. After doing this investigation, patient is asked to go for the fasting for about 6 hours before the procedure, and he would be given IV conscious sedation to remain awake but sedated during the procedure. Then he would be given the aspirin of 300 mg dose. To if the patient is suspected with any type of coronary heart disease, then only. Then he would be given the antiplatelet agent like clopidogrel, 600 mg of loading dose, 75 mg of daily dose. Then he would be asked to stop the oral anticoagulant before 24 hours the procedure. Then he would be asked to take the warfarin to prevent the excessive side bleeding which would occur after the procedure, because if we take the radial artery for the cardiac catheterization, it would cause the excessive side bleeding. That's why. Now, other than this, patient is given the heparin of 5000 IU in the IV and atorvastatin. And patient usually doesn't require any type of antibiotic prophylaxis because it is a sterile procedure. Now, during the procedure, we have to follow the various steps. The first step is the vascular access. Second step is the modified RNA test. Third step would be the introduction of the sheath into the radial artery. And the fourth step would be the insertion of the catheter into the coronary artery. And then the dilatation of the narrow segment of the coronary artery and the placement of the stent. And then we will remove the catheter through the radial artery. We have two vascular axes for the cardiac catheterization. First is the radial artery and the second is the femoral artery. But the radial artery is more preferable than the femoral artery because of its several benefits. The first benefit is the quick admission. Second benefit is it requires a less hospitalization hours. Third benefit is it prevents the excessive side bleeding.
Modified Allen test. Ask the patient to raise the hand and tell him to do the opening and the closing of the hand for several times. Then ask him to squeeze it tightly. Then occlude the radial artery and the ulnar artery. Then tell the patient to open the fist. We can see the blanching of the whole hand, first in the fingertips, then in the hand. Then we need to release the radial artery first. We can see the blood return occurs within the 5 seconds. If the blood return does not occur within the 5 to 15 seconds, it means the radial artery is not patent. Similarly, the same test should be done with the ulnar artery. And close the hand. Open the hand. See, the blood return again occurs within the 5 seconds. It means the ulnar artery is also patent. It confirms that the person is having the dual blood supply to the hand and is eligible for doing the angioplasty.
The sheath is introduced. Through that sheath, we will insert the catheter. That catheter will have the diacritic tip. Now, when the catheter is inserted into the coronary artery, it is having the diacritic tip. So that dye will be released into the coronary artery. Simultaneously, we have to do the fluoroscopy. And we will get the real-time image of blockage area of the coronary artery. Here the blockage area is LAD, that is left anterior descending artery.
Students, I will show you the procedure of angioplasty on the dummy model of the heart. Now, I will insert a catheter from the radial artery. The catheter is reached to the coronary artery. Now, gradually, it reached to the left anterior descending artery. Now the dilatation of the balloon is started. Look at this, students. Increase in the size of balloon is gradually and the balloon become large. It compresses the fatty tissue of the artery. The narrow coronary artery, now it become large opening. Now the balloon is gradually deflated. And circulation is re-established. With the help of the catheter, stent is reached to the coronary artery. Now it's reached to the left anterior descending artery. Now we again inflate the balloon to fix the stent. We remove the catheter from the stent. Complications of this procedure are, first, infection and bleeding at the catheter inserted side, second, cardiac arrhythmia, third, chest pain, and fourth, rupture of coronary artery. Post discharge care, we remember from the mnemonics A, B, C, D, and E. A for antiplatelet and anti-anginal, B for beta blocker and blood pressure control, C for cholesterol lowering agent and cigarette cessation, D for diet and diabetes control, and E stand for exercise and education.
Discuss about post-procedure monitoring, in which first neurovascular checkup,
Neurovascular checkup below the canthal incipient side for the pulse, color and sensation of the patient. Second, ECG monitoring for the 24 hours. Third, bed rest for the patient for 4 to 6 hours. And fourth, vigorous use of abdominal muscle for coughing and sneezing. Fifth, monitoring the seat inserted side for the bleeding. Sixth, monitoring the angina. If angina reoccur, then nitroglycerin started and advise the patient for subsequent follow-up.
I begin to